points. Now, what is fixed cross actually? Now, there are different crosses in Mendel's experiment. Now, what are the different crosses? If you see, the test cross is one of them. Even we have back cross, and reciprocal crosses are already done in my previous lectures. If you see the monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross, those lectures. Now, in this test cross, it is nothing but the crossing of F1 individual with their dominant phenotype with its homozygous recessive parent, and that is nothing but test cross is about. Means it is a cross between the F1 hybrid, and that F1 hybrid is a dominant phenotype. The cross between the F1 hybrid, which is a dominant phenotype between the homozygous recessive parent, is called as test cross. And this dominant phenotype, this F1 individual, is a hybrid. Hybrid means, if you take an example of tall character, tall and dwarf character, contrasting character, you will find that capital T, small t is a heterozygous phenotype. So heterozygous is nothing but hybrid, because it is capital T and small t, different alleles in the F1 generation. So that F1 hybrid is crossed with a homozygous recessive parent. We have two parents, one is male and another one is female. One parent is homozygous dominant and other one is homozygous recessive. So this F1 hybrid is crossed with a recessive parent, which is homozygous. Obviously, the recessive parent will be homozygous, because a parent, if it's recessive, it has to be in its similar allele, that is small t, to be expressed as dwarf. And that cross between the two is nothing but called as test cross. Now, why Mendel has to conduct this test cross? What is the reason behind that? Test cross is used to determine or to verify whether the individual exhibiting dominant character are homozygous or heterozygous. That means whatever progeny is obtained in the F2 generation, that progeny that is a dominant character, whether it is homozygous, that is capital T, or heterozygous, that is capital T, small t. Because capital T and capital T and capital T, capital T and capital T, small t, they will give rise to tall plant. That is according to the phenotype. So when you want to know the genotype of it, which cannot be seen externally, then how will you identify the genotype of the homozygous heterozygous plant? But that should be the dominant character, because dominant character can only be represented in the form of homozygous and heterozygous. If you talk about recessive, recessive can be expressed only in the form of homozygous. This is what is actual test cross is all about. Now let's see the diagrammatic, the representation of the test cross. Some more points on test cross. A test cross between a heterozygous dominant, heterozygous means the one which will carry one copy of dominant and a recessive allele each, and the cross between this heterozygous dominant and the recessive parent, whatever progeny is obtained will be in the ratio 1:1. 1:1 means one will be dominant and other one will be recessive. While when there is a cross between homozygous dominant and recessive parent, it will give all dominant progeny. That's the difference. That means if it is heterozygous dominant, cross as capital T, small t, crossing with small t, you get the offspring in the F2 generation as in 1:1 ratio. That is, one will be dominant, other will be recessive, is a ratio. But when you're crossing the homozygous dominant with the recessive parent, whatever offspring obtained, progeny obtained, is all dominant, because it is homozygous, capital T, and this is heterozygous, small t. That's the difference between the two. Then a cross between two pure breeding tolerance is this, capital T, and dwarf TT varieties will give all F1 progeny, tall F1 progeny, That is what is seen in the last sentence over here, last line over here. That is a cross between homozygous dominant, that is capital T, and a dwarf, small t, that is a recessive parent. The progeny obtained will be all tall. Now to test the genotype of F1 progeny, it is crossed with, who it, this F1 progeny is crossed with pure breeding dwarf plant. Okay, that means the heterozygous is the F1 progeny. So this F1 progeny heterozygous is crossed with the dwarf, which is homozygous over here, which is a recessive parent. Okay, breeding dwarf plant. And what does the product obtained, the progeny obtained? The progeny obtained is a tall and dwarf progeny. That is, they are tall. One is the tall, which is dominant. Other one is the dwarf progeny, which is recessive. Now here it is 1:1 ratio. It does not mean one tall plant and one dwarf plant. It means that this much. Now suppose 1,000:1,000. That is 1,000 tall, 1,000 dwarf. Maybe that is 1:1 ratio. So number of plants differs, but the ratio remains the same. That is what is 1:1 ratio, suggesting the tested dominant variety is heterozygous. This is what is a test cross. For what purpose test cross is done? Whether the progeny obtained is heterozygous or homozygous. That is, whether it is capital T, small t, or capital T, capital T. Now, depending upon the ratio or the progeny obtained, we can come to know whether it is heterozygous or homozygous. I repeat, depending upon the ratio, if the ratio obtained in the F2 generation is 1:1, then the cross is done between capital T, small t, and TT. And if we get all the dominant variety in F1, if we get all dominant variety at the last, then the cross is done between homozygous dominant and the homozygous pure recessive. Okay, now what is the next slide? This is the actual Mendel's monohybrid experiment, which I had seen in the previous lecture. This slide is taken over here to explain actual what is a cross. Now, a normal cross in which you have the parent tall and dwarf, this is a monohybrid cross, so only one character is taken. So phenotype, there's a parent phenotype is tall, pure tall, and pure dwarf, and the genotype is capital T, and small t. After the hybridization, the gametogenesis, the gametes are separated. You get capital T over here, you get small t over here, which is nothing but the law of segregation. And then whatever you get, the F1 hybrid is tall. The F1 generation, F1 phenotype is tall, and the genotype is capital T, small t. And after the selfing of this hybrid, capital T, small t, after selfing, what do you get over here? Self-pollination, that is male and the female. What do you get? Here it is capital T, small t, male, capital T, small t, female. There's a crossing, selfing taking place. After selfing taken place, you get this genotype in which you have all the three tall and one dwarf. And this tall is expressed as homozygous capital T, and heterozygous capital T, small t. So here from the genotype, you can understand that one is homozygous, other two is heterozygous, and other one will be dwarf homozygous, because dwarf will express when the alleles are small letters, that is in a recessive condition. There is this, there homozygous condition, so dwarf is expressed at that time. Now in this Punnett checkerboard, what has been shown? The cross taking place, that is capital T, small t over here, so capital T, small t is taken over here. So when that is done, capital T and small t is crossed with capital T and small t. So what is actually done? This capital T and capital T, they are crossed. You get capital T tall, you get capital T and small t, you get tall over here. That is what is now. What's next? Capital T tall, capital T small t tall, then capital T small t, again they are tall, and small t they are dwarf over here. Now in this case, you get three tall and one dwarf. This three tall, it is homozygous as well as heterozygous. Now from the phenotypic ratio, you can come to this monohybrid cross 3:1, and genotypic ratio is 1:2:1. Now the phenotypic shows that is one is tall, the other one is dwarf, but genotypic representation cannot be seen from external, but it has to be undergo the test cross. The test cross is done to identify whether this dominant character is homozygous or heterozygous. I repeat, test cross is done whether to check this tall phenotype is homozygous or heterozygous. That is what is the tall the test cross is done. Now what happens here is, this is a Mendel monohybrid cross, just to represent, to show why actually test cross is done. Because if you know there is no problem of this recess of this dwarf, because dwarf, when it is there, obviously this will be homozygous, it won't be heterozygous. It was only the problem of the dominant, because dominant can be expressed in both condition, one is homozygous, other one is heterozygous. Now let's see what is the next slide. The next slide is diagrammatic representation of a test cross. Now in this, what they have shown, this is homozygous recessive, this is also homozygous recessive. Now what you want to know over here is, what is the phenotype? This is a dominant phenotype. Now you know, need to know the genotype of this particular plant or flower, you can call it as, or for this plant. So what is the genotype of this plant? So the dominant phenotype can be in homozygous condition, they can be in heterozygous condition as well. So when I'm saying it is a homozygous, so WW violet color, and when I'm saying is heterozygous, W, one capital W and other one is small w. So this is what is the dominant phenotype, which whose genotype we don't know, that's a question mark given over here, whose genotype is unknown. So this WW, which is homozygous, is crossed with homozygous recessive parent. Check out here, WW homozygous is crossed with homozygous recessive parent. So when that is done, so this homozygous recessive is small w, so this is small w male and this is a female, or vice versa. Now when this is done, so that is, this is male and this is female, this is homozygous, this is heterozygous, this is dominant, this is recessive. So when this is done, the cross between WW, you get this capital W small w, capital W small w, again capital W small w, you get here capital W small w, you get here. That means what is the result? All the flowers are violet. That means all the flowers are dominant. That means what is the interpretation? The unknown flower is homozygous dominant when all the progeny obtained, they are in a dominant phenotype, because the unknown flower is dominant, homozygous dominant, because all the flowers are violet in color. But the same thing when you check out here, again you are crossing the homozygous recessive parent with that of the heterozygous dominant. You are crossing with the heterozygous dominant of F1 hybrid. When you are doing that, you don't know what is the genotype of this. You are crossing with an unknown thing. So you want to know what type of genotype is this. That is the reason you are crossing. You want to know what type of genotype is this. That's the reason why you're crossing over here. And when you get the product, based on the product, you come to know, yes, this is a homozygous condition. So in this case, what is the situation? Here we are using a heterozygous. Here this is an unknown. So here it is heterozygous. Now this recessive one, the parent recessive one, homozygous one, is crossed with a heterozygous dominant. When that is done, capital W, small w, this is a Punnett checker. This capital W small w is over here, you get this is WW small, although both the small, you get here the both the W small, you get over here. That is violet flower you're getting as well as white flower you're getting. Half is violet, other one is half is white. That means it is 1:1 ratio. Then this 1:1 ratio, it indicates that the genotype of the the dominant is nothing but heterozygous. And if you're getting all the dominant character, it is homozygous. If you're getting 1:1 ratio, then the dominant one is heterozygous. This is what is a representation of a test cross. What is this now? Now in this case, again the same. You have the recessive parent, which is homozygous, indicated as small y, which is green in color. You have a dominant one, y, but you don't know whether it is homozygous or heterozygous. Now the question mark over here is representing whether it is a capital Y or whether it is small y. That is, whether it is, if it is capital Y, it will be homozygous, and if it is small y, it will be heterozygous. Next, gametes from parent of unknown genotype. They are taking the gametes from parent of unknown genotype. Means capital Y, small y they have taken, and these are the gamete from the recessive parent. When these are crossed, what is the situation over here? So here, capital Y, small y, capital Y, small y. Here it is again question mark. What it is, we don't know. So capital, we take, when one case we are taking it as capital small y. So capital Y, homozygous condition we are saying. So if you're doing that, you get capital Y, small y. And then capital Y, Y. And here again, they're taken capital Y, Y. So what does it showing? A test cross resulting in all dominant offspring indicates that the parent is homozygous dominant. Means here what this is showing, that all are having the dominant character. This indicates that this is a homozygous dominant because you're writing here capital Y. Now in this case, gametes from parent of unknown genotype, and over here gametes from the recessive parent. If this is done like this, that means again you're crossing capital Y, small y. This is crossing and you're getting capital Y, small y. And over here what is done, you don't run. Suppose you take it, this you took it as homozygous. Now here you take it as small y. So small y and small y, you get small y, which is homozygous. Again, you're getting capital Y, small y over here. Here you're getting small y over here. So what does it indicate? You have two yellow seed and two green seed. That means it is 1:1 ratio of yellow and green offspring, indicating that the parent is heterozygous. So depending upon the ratio of the progeny obtained, you can come to know what is the genotype of the parent. So unknown genotype can be calculated by the test cross by knowing what is the ratio obtained at the end of the F2 generation. So that's why test cross is used over here. Now in this case, that was about monohybrid in which you took the single character, single contrasting character. So when I will take a dihybrid test cross, when I'm taking two characters, that is one contrasting character is the round one. Round means what is the seed shape? Is it round or wrinkled? In this, round is dominant, wrinkled is recessive. And the other color of the seed is yellow, which is dominant, and green is again recessive. So the genotypes are capital R, small r. Yellow is capital Y, small y. Here the wrinkled genotype is capital R, capital small r, small r. Green is small y, small y. Now you separate the gametes. You have R, RY. R, capital R goes with capital Y. Capital R goes with small y. Small r goes with capital Y. Small r goes with small y. So if this is done, in this case, the gamete formation takes place, gamete separation takes place like this. And in this case, it will be only one because these are recessive, all are homozygous. So one is small r, the other one is small y. Now in this case, the genotypes will be what? This will be male or this will be female or vice versa, it can be other. And is a cross done. And when the cross is done, in this all the four, now here it's half mentioned, but all the other four tables, three tables will be the same. RY, RY, RY. Here just for simplicity, we have shown it like this. But you have to write down all the four tables. Now here, this RY crosses with this RY, you get this. This crosses with this, you get this. This crosses with this, you get this. This crosses with this, you get this. Now at this time, what is the phenotype? The phenotype you can see, this is round yellow, this is round green, this is green, this is wrinkled yellow and this is wrinkled green. That means what is this proportion over here? The proportion is out of this four, out of this 1, 2, 3, 4, out of this four, 1/4, that is 25% is round yellow, the other 25% is round green, the other 25% is wrinkled yellow, the other 25% is wrinkled green. So this is, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. This is again 1:1:1:1 ratio because it's 25%, 25%, 25%, 25%. So it is 1:1:1:1 ratio. They're getting 4 over here. That means this is because it's a hybrid cross. In dihybrid cross, what is the phenotypic ratio? 9:3:3:1. But when you're doing the test cross, it is 1:1:1:1 because you're using two contrasting characters. What are the points to remember over here? Now, what points? What you came to know about a test cross is all about. Now, why is it done? To find out what is the genotype of an organism, whether it is homozygous dominant or heterozygous dominant. That is the reason why test cross is done. What is next? How is it done? Organism of unknown genotype is mated with a homozygous recessive parent. What has been done? How is it done? Organism of unknown genotype is crossed with the homozygous recessive parent. That is what, how is it done? That means this dominant phenotype is unknown phenotype, capital P, homozygous it can be, capital P, small p, heterozygous it can be because it is dominant. This is a recessive parent who will have the genotype as small p. When this is crossed with this, you will come to know what is the genotype of this. That is, how will you draw a conclusion? Look at the offspring phenotypic ratio. At the end, whatever you get, that is nothing but the phenotypic ratio. At the end, whatever you get. Okay, that's all for today's lecture. Thank you.